time block open houses, time block for door knocking. There's things that you need to time block, and that way you don't miss him. We're all busy. Like, if I'm as busy as can be with all the businesses we have going on and all the things we have going on, and I time block, that everybody should be able to time block. There's no reason why you shouldn't time, because every day you need to look for new business. Real estate and mortgage are a relationship business. The reason why I got to where I am today is because of relationships. Before this, I was talking to Bobby Castro, and you guys see a lot of companies, brand new companies, smaller companies, right? So when you grow a company, investors, they look for a company's revenue. Like, how many agents do they have? How much revenue are they bringing in? How many deals are they closing? Right now, most mortgage companies and real estate companies are not closing anything, meaning the company is not worth anything. So I was talking about Bobby because now we're taking that next big step. What does that mean? Ambiance Realty and mortgage guys, TMG Lending, they're worth a lot of money because we are the only ones that are closing deals. So now we're talking to investors. We're talking about, now we have a lot of offers of loans that we could get. And I'm talking about multi-million dollar loans and investors that want to pitch in to help blow up the company, because they see our audience, they see our influence that we have. So they know that 2023 is going to be huge. And with the most resources and the best relationships, you can take over. So it's going to be like a really, really fun 2023, because we have the resources and we have the relationships. So it's very, very, very fun. But if I didn't work on relationships, I wouldn't have that. I would be like all the people that are trying to start new companies at the worst time, especially in mortgage and real estate, and they have no resources, no relationships. I focused on this ever since I got into the business. Every client that I talked to, I made them my friend. I made them feel happy. I made them feel good about themselves. If you want to get laid, if you want to go get business, if you want to convince your kids for anything, you got to make them feel happy. You got to make them feel important. Most people, they just ask for the sale. Hey, you want to refinance? Hey, you want to list your house? You got to make people feel good. You got to make people like you. When you make people happy, you sell happiness, you create those relationships, which lead to the relationships I created, which leads to people that are successful right now have a lot of relationships. If you close a lot of deals, it's because you have the right relationships, not the bad relationships. So remember, you're not in real estate, you're not selling homes or mortgage. You're building relationships. The more relationships you build, the more money you're gonna make, the more people you're gonna help. So this is something that I do. I time block for veggies. Veggies are things that taste nasty that give you the best results, right? They give you the highest ROI, but a lot of people don't eat veggies. You don't like veggies, but they're good for you. So who likes to study, self-improve, work on themselves? Not a lot of people. I know Chris worked on him. He's not a big reader from what I know about him, but he worked so much, made so many mistakes that he polished up and became great. That's, to me, studying. That's working on himself, because you mess up the first times, but then you get better every time you do it. And now it's so natural for him that he became one of the greatest salespeople in the world. So you gotta make time, you gotta time block to get better, to make phone calls. How many of you make a lot of phone calls? A lot? Like, what's a lot? Like, who makes the most phone calls?
I make like 50 a day.
50 phone calls a day? Anybody make more than that? I know Chris does like 1,000 phone calls a day, but anybody besides Chris make more than 50 calls?
Victoria?
How many?
Around 50.
I'm pretty sure a lot of people, most of you don't make a lot of phone calls. So 50 phone calls, that's really good. Time block for health, nutrition, and exercise. Without nutrition and exercise, I wouldn't be where I am. Some people are, but people ask me, hey, how do you keep your mindset so strong? Because I work out and I eat right. Not all the time, but 80% of the time, I like to eat right and work out, exercise. Social media, I time block to post, because you gotta post a lot. I'll show you later. Relationships, time block to create relationships. If you keep people happy, even if a deal doesn't go the right way, they're gonna be loyal to you because you make them feel happy. You make them feel important. So relationships, the more relationships you build, that's how you become number one in your space. So I'm the type that I never stop. Like I got 24 hours in a day. I need 6 hours to sleep. And other than that, I'm working 16, 18 hours a day. Last year, I was working 16, 18 hours a day. For the past 10 years, the only difference this year is that now I got to say no to more people, because now there's a lot of people that just want to take, or feed you gossip and drama, and I don't have time for that. So now those people, now I say, no, I can't do dinner with you. No, I can't do lunch with you. No, I can't jump on a call with you. And I eliminate those people, and now I have more time. So now it gives me more time, 2 to 4. I time block, and I call all my database. I have a huge database. So I call all my past database, and every conversation is about 30 minutes to an hour, because my conversion rate is like 99.9%. I'm not kidding. Like I close everybody because I know how to talk to them. This is one of the best books you'll ever get, How to Win and Influence Friends. So make sure if you don't have this book, get it. I'll show you a few pages. But time block. There's no excuse why you shouldn't be calling from 2 to 4 every single day. Time block open houses. Time block for door knocking. There's things that you need to time block, and that way you don't miss him. We're all busy. Like if I'm as busy as can be with all the businesses we have going on and all the things we have going on, and I time block, then everybody should be able to time block. There's no reason why you shouldn't time block, because every day you need to look for new business. I can teach you how to make a lot of money. As when I was a full-time originator, I made a lot of money. $2 million a year easy, just being an originator. So I know how to do it, but you guys have to execute. So this is basic shit, but people can't do basic shit nowadays. So this is my script, very easy. I call them and I ask them about the family, that's it. Never forget their names. Study them before you call them. So before you call them, don't just call them and wing it, you gotta study it. If I'm gonna meet Lorena one day, I'm gonna study her. Like I'm gonna look through her Instagram, I'm gonna look through her stories, I'm gonna look through her friends, I'm gonna see like, okay, does she like the Dodgers or the Angels? Cause I'm not gonna fuck it up and I'm gonna go like, hey, let me talk, I'm not gonna talk about the Angels if she likes the Dodgers, because you gotta talk about things people like to make them like you. Names, write them down. And then when you're genuine, they're gonna bring out, I've been thinking about calling you. I wanna list my house, I wanna refinance, I need some cash. Oh, you know what, my friend, I got a referral for you. So that's my script, very easy, very easy. And it's the same script I've been following ever since I started going out to bars, dates, same script. How's your family? What do you like to do? Anna, what do you do for fun? Anna, do you have any brothers or sisters? Anna, what's your favorite color? Anna, what's your favorite car? Anna, do you like going to the zoo? Do you like going to Disneyland? It's all about what does the person in front of me like, not what I like. What do they like? When you talk about what they like, then you win them. And then it becomes an easy close. 95% is creating that connection, and 5% is the close. I called a client yesterday, 2 to 4. Send a deal to Patty. Client needs cash. When people need cash, they don't care if the interest rate is at 10%. So stop focusing on things you can't control. You can't control other people's production. You can't control people leaving your life or your business. You can control your activity and your output. Focus on what you could control. MMAs, money-making activities. My time is very valuable, and so is yours. So you can't spend time on anything that's not gonna put money in your pocket. Like this puts money in my pocket. The more I help everyone, the more money everybody makes, including myself. I have time for this. I don't have time to go spend an hour, 2 hours long lunch unless it's gonna put money in my pocket. So you gotta be very efficient with your time and very selective. Just because there's 4 events, 5 events in a month doesn't mean you have to go to all of them. Go to the ones that are gonna feed you the most, the ones that make sense. Not all of them make sense. Persistence beats talent. There could be the most talented person that doesn't wanna work hard, that's lazy. I know a lot of you know those people. It doesn't matter how talented you are if you don't work hard and you're not persistent. Like you think my favorite thing to do is 2 to 4 make phone calls? You think I love waking up 4 or 5 in the morning? You think I like doing lives at 11 p.m. sometimes? I don't. But I know that I will not fail, and I know that I won't quit ever, because I know that every year I gotta get better. So I know that if I have to be even more persistent, I'm gonna be more persistent. Because there are people that are more talented than me, but there ain't no people that work harder than me. You control that. You can't control how talented you are, but you could control how hard you work. Culture is everything. Just remember that. Culture beats strategy all day long. And if you don't know what culture is, look it up in the dictionary. Look, right now, you might be saying, oh, well, right now it's like, is it like 2008? Is it worse? Is it better? What's gonna happen? It's the hugest opportunity of your life right now because there's no competition. So it's your time to shine right now. You have less competition. Is there less business? I don't think so. Maybe there is, but there's less competition. So you have more options now. So remember right now, you might be, maybe you had you started 2008. You went through a little cycle where you didn't do good. Then you did better. Maybe last year, that last 2 years, you had the best years of your life. And then this year, it's not looking like that. Maybe this year you're a little down. Maybe you're 50% down, but you're not out. Remember, maybe right now you're in chapter 20. You went through chapter 1 through 20. You're in chapter 21. In 5 years from now, when you look back and you're like, fuck, hey, Albert, Anna's going to be like, fuck, Albert, you know what? I remember in 2022, towards the end, all these people that started new companies or went somewhere else and they went out of business. Now they're working at IHOP. And you guys, and we were like, it was hard and we had to work hard. And I remember, Albert, you were making phone calls from 2 to 4 and you were doing things that I've never seen you do, but you led, you showed us through example. And 5 years from now, we're like looking back and we're like, fuck, our company's worth $1 billion. And we're like, damn. So what are you gonna create? What's gonna be the end of your book? Just because this year you gotta make changes, it doesn't mean it's the end. How are you gonna end? Are you gonna stop or are you gonna continue? It's up to you. We can't change what's going on. We can't control that, but you could control what you're gonna do. So if you gotta be on the field four times a week like Chris, this is nothing new, by the way. Like, he's been doing that for like the past 10 years or more. Am I right or wrong?
Right.
He's not changing anything. He's used to that. But a lot of people right now are being forced to have to do it because they weren't used to it. They weren't doing it. They slacked off. They thought it was going to be like this all the time.